practically anything with a 3D printer. All you need is filament, the plastic feedstock the printer uses to materialize your items.
It is a fan duct, basically.
And Tyler McNanny invented Filibot, a machine to recycle plastic into filament.
We're working towards being able to recycle the widest range of plastics, so like soda bottles, milk jugs, really any plastic that you put in your recycling bin, we want to be able to turn it into a 3D print.
Right now, his machines work with the kinds of plastic used for Legos, remote control cases, yogurt containers, even certain kinds of luggage and office items. And of course, any 3D print that didn't come out exactly the way you planned.
This one is coming up on the edge. We could throw that in our system.
Just put the plastic into a grinder, and then put it into the filibot.
You put the pellets in. Melting the plastic first, gets pressurized, heated up here, and then squirts out the nozzle.
Tyler and his team assemble and package filibot in Barrie, and continue to work on design there as well. As 3D printing becomes cheaper, better, and more common, he says filibot has several selling points.
It allows for really anyone to have that closed-loop recycling right where they are.
So it helps the environment and saves money. But he also says it allows people to customize their filament.
We have a plastic right now that we work with that has 80% brass in it. And it's really heavy. It feels like the metal. And you can polish it and make it look like the metal.
He says that ability to make your own kind of filament has a lot of big-name companies buying filibot. He says NASA, Google X, Ford, and Toyota are all customers, as well as the Pentagon and many more. He's pleased with what he's done so far, but...
I'm not done yet.
He's planning for more models that work with more materials in an industry that he believes will continue to matter more and more. Current filibot models run between $500 and $2,000.